Meet Peter. At 16, he's thinking about the future, education, employment, and increasing his skills. But all these are affected by one thing. Peter is stateless.
This is my passport and my ID card. They all identify me as a Kenyan national. In many ways, I take this for granted. But not everyone has a nationality. Some people are stateless, meaning they don't have these documents. This means they might not be able to go to school, travel abroad, or even get a job. And this has a big effect on their lives.
Right now I'm in Form 3. Next year I have to do my end of secondary education. And I have to have the certificates, my birth certificates and the rest. But I cannot get that birth certificate because I'm not recognized in Kenya. So what I have to do is to end my studies in Form 3. I cannot do anything. I have to shatter my dreams and my goals.
Peter's community speaks a language you might not expect to hear in Nairobi. It's Shona, one of the official languages of Zimbabwe. The community here's ancestors arrived from Zimbabwe in 1960 as Christian missionaries, and decades later, they are neither legally Kenyan or Zimbabwean. Most people in the community do jobs like carpentry and basket weaving, as not having document makes it hard for them to get jobs or finish their education. They cannot travel outside Kenya and live in fear of being arrested.
When you don't have an ID, you're faced with many challenges. Sometimes it's hard to sell furniture to a client. You can get a good client, but they require that you have an ID. Sometimes I want to get out of the country to work, and it's impossible without one. We would like the government to help us.
If the government would just help us get identification cards, we will be very happy. It's even hard to go to town. The police can arrest you and ask you for an ID. There's a time people are being asked for IDs in town. I left my luggage and ran away because I have no ID.
The UN estimates that there are at least 10 million stateless people around the world. In Africa, more than 700,000 people are stateless. The majority of these are in Ivory Coast. When the country became independent, a lot of people didn't claim citizenship when laws changed. Neither could their children or future generations. So what has been done to solve this issue? Well, the African Union say they're discussing making nationality an essential human right. There's also been the idea of an African Union passport, which will make everyone on the continent an African citizen. But for people like Peter, these are long-term solutions and won't help him get back to school anytime soon.